Maria Antonia Sabari Singzon was born on December 15, 1920, in the beautiful town of Kalbiga, Samar. She is the fifth of eight children of Judge Vicente Singzon and Rosario Sabari. Her siblings are Geronimo, Mercedes, Doroteo, Pablo, and Vicentito. At the age of seven, Maria left her rustic life in Kalbiga when she was sent by her aunt, Sor Filomena Sabari, to study at La Concordia College in Manila. She was very sickly and was given extra dinner and time to sleep in Concordia. Despite her poor health, she was naughty and caused problems for the good nuns of the school. One time, Maria locked a nun out of a classroom. Then, against school rules, she picked up and ate an unripe green fruit from the mango trees in the school. As punishment, she was made to stand on a bench in the dining room and given no dinner. Another time, Maria and her friends soaked red crepe paper in the holy water font in the chapel, causing the white bibs of the nuns to get dotted with red marks. One New Year's Day, Maria and her friends threw firecrackers into the recreation room of the nuns. As punishment, they were made to kneel with outstretched arms and kiss the floor. Maria asked why she was being made to kiss the dirty floor after being taught hygiene and sanitation in class. 10 years and countless punishments later, Maria eventually outgrew her naughty antics into a lovely, well-behaved young woman. At the age of 17, despite getting grades of F in character and conduct in previous years, Maria graduated from high school as the class salutatorian. After graduation, Maruhing, as Maria is fondly called, went home to Kalbiga for a vacation. She had planned on pursuing a nursing degree in San Juan de Dios in Manila. However, she was persuaded by her cousins to take the teacher's competitive test in Catbalogan. She took the test just for fun, but placed second in the exams. The supervisors were ready to offer her a spot in their schools. Lola Sayong, her mother, forced her to accept a position in one of the biggest elementary schools in Samar, in Lawang. Maruhing cried day and night, for she could not see herself as a teacher at age 17, but she was eventually forced to yield. In Laoyang, Maruhing was assigned to teach grade 2. When she walked to her school wearing school shoes and socks and a Mickey Mouse ribbon on her head, people looked out their windows to see the teacher, who was still a child. They even observed her from the door and windows of her classroom. Every time she came home from school, she cried herself to sleep. However, her co-teachers rallied behind her. After 7 months, she became a demonstration teacher. Mr. Plamenco, her principal teacher, requested that she wear high heels and nylons. A few months after Loye Sayong and Maruhing arrived in Laoyang, the mayor asked Lola Sayong's permission for Maruhing to be a candidate in the town beauty pageant. Lola Sayong agreed so as not to antagonize the mayor, but she and Maruhing did not know anybody in Laoyang. Who would they sell tickets to? Somehow they managed to sell tickets in Catarman, and Maruhing was crowned Miss Visayas. On May 28, 1945, towards the end of World War II, when Kalbiga was still occupied by the Japanese, Maruhing married Mariano Daradao Froilan of Kalbiga. Maruhing and Maruhing were blessed with eight children: Munina, Bing, Toti, Mark, Chito, Mylene, Mina, and Marichen. They moved to Catbalogan, where Maruhing worked as a civil engineer and Maruhing as an elementary school teacher. In 1980, after teaching for 42 years, Maruhing received an award as the most outstanding teacher of Region 8, given by the Secretary of Education of the Philippines. The following year, she finished her Master's in Education, Major in Administration and Supervision, Minor in English. She became the principal teacher of Ginsarogan Elementary School. Later on, she taught Spanish at Samar College in Catbalogan. Mark, their fourth child, had enlisted in the U.S. Navy in 1978 and petitioned Marining and Maruhing for immigration to the United States. While waiting for their green cards, they stayed with their nephew Romolo Jacala and family in Guam, where Maruhing babysat the youngest daughter, Anna. They moved to Arlington, Virginia, to be with Mark, who was stationed there. When Mark was transferred to an overseas duty station, they moved to Winter Haven, Florida, to be the companions of their cousin, Nene Nabong. On July 12, 1986, Marining died of heart failure and was flown back to the Philippines. He was laid to rest in Loyola Memorial Park in Paranaque, Manila. Maruhing went to L.A., California, to await the realization of her and Marining's dream, which was to give their children a brighter future in the land of opportunity. In 1989, 8 years after Maruhing petitioned them for immigration, Bing, Chito, Mylene, and Marichen finally made that dream come true. Maruhing is now enjoying life with her children, grandchildren, great-grandchildren, relatives, and friends in Glendale, California. Among her favorite pastimes are playing mahjong and the slot machines. She enjoys attending social and religious functions. And as long as she does not have to fly, or when she can overcome her fear of flying, she goes places. God has blessed Maruhing, and we pray He continues to do so. Let us praise and thank the Lord Almighty for keeping her in His care, through sunny days as well as the storms, hills, and valleys of her life. Thank you, Lord, for allowing her to celebrate her first 90 years with family, relatives, and friends.